been with the Boys Club in one way or the other, off and on, since probably about 1947, 1948, when I was a kid. When I came through, well, okay, there was the YMCA and the Boys Club and the Boy Scouts. The YMCA cost money, and we had none. And the Boys Club was 50 cents a year, you know, something that you could really, well, you could afford.
I know when I was a kid, and I guess everybody says that, it seems that there were more things. There was the recreation center downtown. There were more things open for kids, and the Boys Club was a big part of it back then for us.
Once I got here, it was like finding a home, because, again, it's just, there's kids around, there's parents, there's volunteers. It's a really great atmosphere to be in and work in, and it's a lot of fun.
The Boys Club's always been a really warm and inviting place, but if you walk in there now, that place is absolutely beautiful. I mean, I've got this 40-acre campus here, and I'm really jealous because their facilities across the street are better.
When I first saw the Boys Club as a kid, I thought it was a big, wonderful, great place, you know, and as I grew up, it grew older, and it grew smaller. The facility that I knew that I thought was huge was really inadequate for a while, but I think the remodeling that has been done here, the addition as far as staff and volunteers and types of programs, this facility I think is second to none.
The club provides a home for a lot of kids, a home away from home. And you got to remember that a lot of the children that are active in the club are the traditional at-risk youth. And they're children that don't necessarily have some of the benefits of more privileged children. The club gives them an opportunity to have a very positive place, a very safe place to come, and a place to grow and gain the life skills that they need to be successful.
I see us doing that, plus providing a place for children just to come and have fun in a safe environment. Not so much trying to replace the parents or the school system. Everyone's trying to do the best that they can with the resources that they have, and I just see it as a supplementary role. You know, if we can impact the schools and make the student in the school a little bit better, then we help the school be a better place.
Having the Boys Club there, it gives kids a significant choice and a really good choice to be in a comfortable place and have fun in a really healthy way. When I'm over there, the kids that are there, the kids that really need this place. I mean, they're the kids that they maybe come from a broken home, or they just don't have the facilities or the support at home, and they can find it over there. They can, if they don't have the love in their house, then they'll find it at the Boys Club.
The club has seen a very drastic change over the last couple of years. Approximately 2 years ago, we set off on a capital campaign to raise approximately $1.5 million, which started off really as just a renovation of our gym to make it earthquake safe and turned into a major renovation of the club.
Society is moving much faster now, and as an organization that is community-based, we have to move at that same pace to keep up with the demand. We want people from Montecito to feel welcome here, from Upper East Side, Lower East Side, the West Side, Santa Barbara, Goleta. And it was a building that was 50 years old. It was just old and needed a change. And we needed a change as a organization to fit the 90s.
And Kevin did have a vision, and that vision got reduced to a program called Today and Tomorrow's Children. And that was a vision of creating the supermarket of activities in one location. And that was really the blueprint for the capital campaign and for the renovation of the facility to create all these different learning centers, if you will, throughout the club.
The whole purpose of this thing is to keep those kids busy and interested. They will not get busy if they're not interested. Once they're interested and busy and they're pursuing whatever their interests are, whether it's in arts and crafts or in the computer rooms or in sports, then there is no room for mischief.
The renovation has enabled us to offer a lot more programs to the boys and girls of the club. And in that way, we're just a stronger organization. We've actually grown in size. We've been able to add a dance room, which has enabled us to add folklorico and break dancing and flamenco. And this year, we're participating in the fiesta festivities. We've increased the size of our Learning Resource Center, and right now we have 25 working computers with the internet and Excel and different office applications. We have a new library, which has enabled us to offer tutoring and a homework club. So we really are a lot stronger and have been able to offer more programs to more kids.
We used to have 3 computers for the last 5 years. And as you can see now, we have access of more than 20 computers.
This building was run down, and having repainted it, redone the walls, redone everything in here, I think has given the kids an uplift. They feel proud about it. They like being here. It's exciting. It's an exciting place to be now.
We are currently looking at training them in carpentry skills, culinary skills, and printer press skills. And the Boys Club themselves has all the state-of-the-art equipment for that.
I've taught printing for about 30 years. And I have students that are working all over town in print shops, doing very well, in some of the best shops in town.
I think a lot of people have driven by the facility and over the years never really paid too much attention to it because it was sort of just there. Now it stands out, and people have commented on how great the facility looks, and the people that have gone through the facility and actually seen the changes and opportunities that are now presented to the children are really excited about what we can provide.
And of course, a major factor was that we wanted to get the girls involved more.
For us, our number one goal is to make our membership in the next 3 to 4 years 50% male and female. The world has changed. It's just not a man's world anymore. It's a much more inclusive world, so we have to make sure that we are giving children skills to deal with all demographics, nationalities, ethnicities, genders.
We do have a lot of girls participating in all of the different programs, including athletics and dance, but I really think that our numbers need to increase, and we're working on that at this point with different programs. We hope to offer volleyball this fall, a club volleyball team, and work the women into more soccer and more basketball and more arts and crafts and more dance. So it is definitely a program that we're trying to increase with the girls.
It's a far more diverse, modern club to help give kids the skills that they need to survive in today's world.
We definitely have a good relationship with the parents of a lot of the members who help and do volunteer coaching. So we have a really good interaction with everyone in the community, whether it's a board member, a parent, or a child.
They've been really our structure, our backbone, all the things that we didn't have as the organizational skills, they brought into the picture. We couldn't have done it without them.
We do a liaison between the community. I try to have the community come in and work here and have the children go out. It gives them a chance to see what other artists are doing, what the community actually has to offer, and the community can see what we're doing down here. We enter several different shows that are community oriented.
Well, what I did see and what we have seen is the loss of hope for children, and that's the scariest thing for me. That's what I saw as our vision for the new facility and the new organization, or the enhanced organization, I should say, was reinstilling that hope, that sense of hope, and there's opportunity out there and some options in life.
I think one of the most exciting things about this club is if you're able to visit the club at 5 or 6 o'clock in the afternoon, and it is the most rewarding experience to walk through the club and take a look at a library full of kids studying, a computer room full of kids on computers, the game room is full of activities, people dancing in the dance studio, the art room is going, there's so many things happening and so many opportunities for the kids to participate in. It's just a tremendous visual and personal experience to walk through at that time of day.
If I could say one thing to the people that are watching us, I would say support the Boys Club both financially and as volunteers. Come by and see what you can do.
I'm really proud that in my life that I've been a part of it, and I really like the direction that it's taking. It's the kids that are there are getting a really, they're having a good time and they're getting some very positive things.
This is a great place to be, whether you're a volunteer or a child or a staff member. It's such a great environment, it's very positive, there's always something fun to do.
It's a safe, positive place for their kids to come in and explore the different medias, the different things that they'd like to do as a child so they can be a better adult.
When they help us, they're helping themselves, because these kids are tomorrow's lawyers, doctors, presidents, thieves, and what have you. So if we get them on the right track, we're ensuring our future, the future, not only our immediate future, but the next generation and the generation thereafter.